How many blinks does the average person blink in a day? How about in a week, a month, or a lifetime? And how much time does that person then spend during their lives with their eyes closed because they're mid-blink? Unsurprisingly, finding an answer for any of those questions is far from an exact science. It all depends on massive variables like life expectancy, leap years, and how much time you spend sleeping. But it is possible to get a ballpark figure. Say you blink every 4 seconds on average. That means 15 blinks a minute, 900 an hour, and 14,400 a day if you sleep for 8 hours. That's 5,256,000 in a non-leap year, and 394,200,000 blinks in a lifetime if you live to be 75. As for the time spent with your eyes actually closed, again, the data varies. But if we said that each blink lasts for 1/5 of a second, and for ease, let's round our 394,200,000 lifetime blinks up to a simpler 400 million instead. That means we spend around 80 million seconds blinking all the blinks we ever blink. Bizarrely, that's 22,222.22 recurring hours, which is 925 days, which is 2.5 years. Based on all of the above, we all spend 2.5 years of our lives with our eyes closed because we're blinking. Already, that realization could feel quite disconcerting, like it's almost 1,000 days of inescapably lost time. However, perhaps all is not lost. And in fact, maybe blinking, rather than a waste of time, is actually the most exciting thing that any of us ever do. To find out why, we need to head on over to the other side. This is Unveiled. And today we're answering the extraordinary question, do we enter a parallel universe when we blink? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content? The act of blinking is an essential bodily function to keep our eyes moist and free of debris. It's also an involuntary action. None of us chooses when to blink. Our bodies just ensure that we do, time and time again, like clockwork. It's not something that anyone typically questions. But actually, thanks to some of the most bizarre arms of modern theoretical science, there could also be an all-new world every single time our eyes close. As is so often the case, blinking into a parallel universe is an idea that ties to the ever-increasing murkiness of quantum mechanics, and more specifically, quantum superposition. This is a fundamental property of particles in the quantum realm. It describes how they can occupy multiple locations, energy levels, spin directions, multiple states simultaneously, and is in contrast to a classical understanding of reality, where objects can only ever be in one state at a time. For example, a coin. Classically, it can be either heads or tails, but at the quantum level, it can be both heads and tails at once. Its quantum state is a superposition of both possibilities. And ultimately, it's the same principle for every other possible thing you could imagine. From here, we can apply the many worlds interpretation, a famous theory as to how the world really works. It takes things even further by suggesting that every possible outcome of any event ever, including any quantum event, actually does occur, but in separate branching universes. It says that every choice you make and every event that unfolds should spawn new worlds where the consequences of that moment are played out. It's easy to picture if, say, you're at a fork in a literal road and you take either the left or right turn. But really, this kind of split is happening all the time, all around us, and perhaps thousands of times a second if we boil it all the way down to the quantum level. Which brings us back to blinking. Because although one blink requires comfortably less than 1 second to complete, it's an action that's actually significantly more dramatic than all of the countless subatomic firings that are endlessly happening at the same time. In this way then, theoretically speaking, it seemingly fits that every time you blink, you at least create parallel universes, as per the many worlds interpretation. That phrase, theoretically speaking, is important though. At present, there's still no clear evidence to confirm that blinking is connected with making or transitioning between these hypothetical planes. It's just that if you accept the many worlds interpretation as true throughout the universe, then it's apparently inevitable. Every time we blink, a new arm of the multiverse is made, just as it is every time you smile, frown, click your fingers, or scratch your nose. Ultimately, though, there is another way of approaching the question and perhaps another avenue down which blink universes do happen. we need to also consider the observer effect and wave function collapse. According again to quantum mechanics, the act of observing something at the quantum level is what forces it to be whatever it's seen as. This, in short, is the wave function collapse. It's when the quantum entity is forced to choose just one state from its superposition of possibilities. In the previous coin example, if we observe the coin, it will either be heads or tails. The act of observation has caused it to essentially choose one or the other. From the point of view of blinking, here's where it could again get pretty interesting. Clearly, when we blink, our eyelids cover our eyes for a brief moment and we do not see what's in front of us. Might it be, then, that this momentary darkness also creates an environment where the observer effect is paused and quantum superposition occurs again? While, as before, this isn't a proven concept, it arguably does make sense within the current understanding of quantum phenomena. It also triggers further questions about the true nature of consciousness and conscious reality. When we blink, our external environment is effectively removed from our conscious experience for the duration of that blink. From moment to moment, it appears inconsequential, but as we found at the beginning of this video, it means that we do not perceive our surroundings for a total of 2.5 years over the course of our lifetimes. That's a lot of time for the world around us to perhaps be suspended in an undetermined state. So can we ever really know what's happening to it without us watching? And in the meantime, where are we, our conscious selves, during our blink time? From a slightly more grounded, less immediately far-fetched position, cosmology and neuroscience offer up some further thoughts. While we often say that something happens in the blink of an eye, it's not always the case that whatever that something was really did just take a fifth of a second to complete. However, scale up to the universe level, and it becomes clear that ultimately, every blink contains infinite possibilities. Perhaps during your last blink, it was precisely then that some far-off star was born out of cosmic dust. Or maybe during your next blink, the orbit of a distant moon will deviate just enough to ensure that it will finally drift away from its host planet. More generally, and applying the universal constant of the speed of light in a vacuum, we can say that during every blink, light travels 37,200 miles, i.e. one-fifth of light speed's 186,000 miles per second, which is the equivalent of traveling 1.5 times around the Earth. Even without parallel worlds, then, it's clear that there is a lot happening every time our eyes briefly shut. From the perspective of neuroscience, it's previously been suggested that blinking could indeed offer more than simply being a function to wet our eyes. It can also be viewed as providing something like a tiny nap for the brain, a process that requires around a 20th of our time all the time. It's something that, to some degree, gives our mental gears a millisecond break, helping to reset attention and perhaps maintain efficiency. In this way, most neuroscientists likely wouldn't conclude that every blink is a portal to a parallel universe. Rather, it's simply a function to transport us into darkness momentarily, which our brains can then cleverly edit out to provide us with the general feeling that we have continuous vision. When you combine that with the realization of all that we missed during a blink, it's quite a trick that the brain is pulling. But still, the fact remains that for that 1/20th of our time, for those 2.5 years of our lifetimes, we are inescapably prevented from seeing what's supposedly right in front of us. And as well as that, if the many worlds interpretation holds true, then we're also spawning all new branches to a quantum multiverse. With every blink, new worlds are made, and perhaps we ourselves are briefly pulled out of our cosmic position. So what do you think? Have you ever thought about blinking quite so much? And are you now maddeningly aware of all the blinks you're blinking right now? As our understanding of the quantum world expands, we may one day find out if there truly is a portal to infinite possibilities within such a basic biological function. As our knowledge of the human brain improves, we might soon discover that blinking is only a physical necessity. As our appreciation of human consciousness evolves, there might be some kind of middle ground between the two. For now, the idea that we could blink into a different universe is hypothetical, theoretical, speculative. It is by no means proven. And yet, with this most simple of acts, could there be more than meets the eye? If you enjoyed this episode, then be sure to stay on the video for another related episode from our recent archive, all about another parallel universe theory. In this world, and maybe in all others, it's starting right about now. From our perspective, the universe is pretty big. 93 billion light-years across, and that's just the observable part of it. The unobservable could well stretch on indefinitely. At last estimate, it's thought that there could be up to 2 trillion galaxies in the universe, with multiple hundreds of billions of stars in each, and multiple trillions of orbiting planets journeying around those hundreds of billions of stars. The scale of the cosmos is simply mind-blowing. So much so that even the entirety of our planet can begin to feel quite small once we consider it alongside everything else. Nevertheless, the stats for Earth are still quite impressive. Our planet has a diameter of 7,926 miles. Its equatorial circumference is 24,901 miles. There's more than 57 million square miles of land on Earth, while the total surface area is more than 196 million square miles. There are upwards of 10,000 cities, and the global population is now comfortably beyond 8 billion people. And yet, according to multiple theories, all of everything that's just been listed might also exist inside a wider structure that's also, actually, smaller than an atom. This is Unveiled, and today we're answering the extraordinary question, are we living on someone else's fingernail? Do you need the big questions answered? Are you constantly curious? Then why not subscribe to Unveiled for more clips like this one, and ring the bell for more thought-provoking content. To start, let's consider the classic children's stories by Dr. Seuss, Horton Hears a Who and How the Grinch Stole Christmas. Both are set in the fictional town of Whoville, which is populated by the Whos. What's interesting, though, is that in both stories, Whoville exists within a speck of dust, and inside a snowflake in some later retellings. The Whos' entire reality is held within an entirely insignificant fleck of matter from our higher plane. On the one hand, it's a clever storytelling gimmick to set Whoville apart from all other fictional worlds. However, on the other, it's a possibility that's no longer thought to be quite so make-believe. We're partway through the 21st century, and theoretical science has learned to incorporate a steady stream of new ideas, theories, and breakthroughs. But arguably none has had more of an impact than the ever-growing field of quantum mechanics. The science of the very small, of subatomic particles and physics, has threatened to rewrite everything we thought we knew about how the world works. In general, researchers have continually found that the conventional laws of physics fall apart when we hit the quantum realm, leading to various suggestions as to the structure of the atom, for example, being akin to the structure of the universe. In many ways, both are unknowable. More specifically, however, due to phenomena such as entanglement and superposition, we know that there are infinite potential variations playing out all the time, forever, at the quantum level. This is especially of interest when it comes to the emergence of quantum computing, as it's thought that the principles at play could one day lead us to incomparably powerful digital technologies. From another point of view, however, all modern research has really revealed is just how intricate matter can be as we travel deeper and deeper inside of it. Perhaps, after all, something like Whoville could be possible. All it would take is a seismic shift in perspective. The shift that's needed arguably happens as soon as you look into black hole cosmology. According to this theory, our entire universe may have originated as a singularity, or a point of infinite density, similar to what we'd expect to discover at the center of a black hole. It then follows that, as this singularity expanded, it created the universe we know today, and indeed is still creating, as we know that the universe is still expanding. To a point, it's a model that follows on from the more general Big Bang theory, which also says that the universe started out as a singularity. The big difference, however, is that black hole cosmology implies 1, a higher plane upon which the conditions for that singularity are made, and 2, that there should be an infinite number of other such singularities, multiplying exponentially as we move up through those higher dimensions. Whenever and wherever there's a black hole, there could, perhaps should, also be a universe. Intriguingly, and as with at the quantum level, the laws of physics inside a black hole are believed to be radically different from those outside of it. For instance, we know that time can slow down or even stop inside a black hole once you move beyond the event horizon. Here then, we find ourselves in a realm where the unpredictable laws of quantum mechanics become dominant, to some degree, just as they already are in the here and now. The key takeaway, though, is that for black hole cosmologists, the observable universe is the inside of a black hole. Everything we've ever known exists as the eventual singularity, deep within a high enough, massive enough, overriding physical structure. Condense all of that down far enough, and perhaps you do eventually reach a Whoville-like reality, one in which our entire universe is held within just a tiny speck. From the point of view of a higher world and a higher being, we might merely be a quantum fluctuation that occurred within a black hole, that occurred within another, and another, and another black hole, and so on, making us and our reality both tiny and bizarrely distorted. It's not as though black hole cosmology is the only theory or concept that's leading us to just such a conclusion, however. Another is that of quantum, or space-time, foam, first proposed by the renowned physicist John Wheeler in the mid-1950s. In short, Wheeler suggested that at the smallest scales of space-time, and we're talking infinitesimally tiny, there exists what can best be described as a foam, the true base layer for physical reality. Wheeler then posited that this foam is made up of constantly fluctuating energy particles forever popping in and out of existence. In more recent times, though, some have pushed this further, asking us to suppose that if these fluctuations can create virtual particles, could they not also spawn entire universes? Some scientists then theorize that within every particle produced in the foam, there could lie another universe with its own laws of physics. Such universes could then be happening and unhappening all the time, birthing and extinguishing, in and out of reality. Again, this is a more than interesting idea when considered from our perspective, looking down into the general murkiness of the quantum realm. But zoom out from us to a higher dimension within which all that we know is tiny, and Wheeler's quantum foam asks us again to ponder our true place in reality. Could it be that our universe is one that's also in flux, one that's also popping in and out of existence? And if so, how concerned should we be about it? On the face of it, it would imply that our time is supremely short, that we might suddenly find ourselves snuffed away into nothingness at any moment. But then again, there's also reason not to worry at all. As with the implications of black hole cosmology, any higher structure that's even close to following Wheeler's quantum foam would likely work within entirely different physical parameters. Just as we know that at the quantum level and inside black holes, time becomes distorted and even disappears, we might expect something similar at any version of a higher dimension. This means that ultimately, it would matter not how long or short, weak or strong our universe might be from a higher perspective, because from our perspective, it works pretty well. And just as most of us give little thought to the subatomic particles that are constantly churning all around us, any proposed higher entity would likely have very little reason to care about us either. Which finally returns us to the question at the top of today's video. Are we living on someone else's fingertip? Through the lenses of black hole cosmology and quantum foam, it would appear that the answer is quite possibly. For so long as we accept that we don't know everything, and we certainly do not know everything, then theoretical science will continue to question even the most fundamental aspects of our reality. And in this instance, it just may be that if you zoom out far enough, if you climb the dimensions high enough, if you reconfigure your understanding dramatically enough, then our 93 billion light years of universe and counting is also condensed into an infinitely small piece of wholly miscible matter, idly blown along by a distant cosmic wind, and perhaps settling somewhere on the palm of another entity's hand. What do you think? Is there anything we missed? Let us know in the comments, check out these other clips from Unveiled, and make sure you subscribe and ring the bell for our latest content.